Good morning. Let us study today great orthogonality theorem. What is called great orthogonality theorem in group theory? From the great orthogonality theorem, the properties of irreducible representations are obtained. This theorem is used to derive or construct the character tables for various point groups. Before we study the great orthogonality theorem, let us study what is symmetry operations. What are symmetry operations? We have already studied the symmetry operations. In mathematics, each symmetry operation is represented by a matrix. Matrix representation. This is the matrix representation for symmetry element. This is the transformation matrix for the symmetry element. So each symmetry operation is represented by a matrix called representation. Okay. If the matrix can be reduced, if the matrix can be for example, 3 by 5 by 5, 6 by 6 matrix is reduced to 2 by 2, 3 by 3, 1 by 1. Okay. So, if the matrix can be reduced by means of similarity transformation, then it is called reducible representation. If the matrix cannot be reduced, then it is called irreducible representation. So, what are called reducible representations? What are called irreducible representations? We have already studied. Please watch the lesson. Why these are important? Because in great orthogonality theorem, it deals with the matrix elements. For example, this is 3 by 3 matrix. There are 9 matrix elements. There are 9 matrix elements. So, it deals with the matrix elements of irreducible representation of a point group. Great orthogonality theorem deals with the matrix elements of irreducible representation of a point group. So this is a mathematical theorem. This is the mathematical form of great orthogonality theorem. This is mathematically stated as follows. We will see further. This is the mathematical form of great orthogonality theorem. According to this theorem, the summation of symmetry operation or corresponds to symmetry operation. Summation of symmetry, all the symmetry operations. Gamma I, this is gamma, capital letter of Greek letter, capital letter of gamma. Okay. Gamma I of R Mn into gamma J of R M prime N prime complex conjugate of this equal to H by square root of Li Lj delta Ij delta Mm prime delta Nn prime. In this, gamma I, gamma J are the ith and jth irreducible representation of a point group. See, to understand this, let us consider water molecule. Let us take water molecule with the point group C2V. There are 4 symmetry operations. Identity element E, C2 axis of symmetry. There are 2 plane of symmetry. We have already studied this. Please watch in group theory. Now, there are 4 irreducible representations for C2V. There are 4 classes. Therefore, there are 4 irreducible representations. Gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3, gamma 4. So, this is gamma I, gamma jth of irreducible representation of a point group. Gamma I of R, Mn, matrix element of, for example, gamma 1 of E of symmetry element, symmetry operation E, Mn. Okay, this is M, first row, and this is first column, second column, third column. This is K1, L1, M1, N1. Let us call KLM1, KLM1, K1, L1. These elements are unknown. Okay, this is the character table. These elements are obtained in the next class by using the great orthogonality theorem. Okay, so now Li, Lj are the dimensions of the ith and jth irreducible representation. For example, this is 4 by 4 matrix. So, dimension 4. Suppose if it is 2 by 2 matrix, 2 cross 2 matrix, then 2. So, Li, Lj are the dimensions of the ith and jth irreducible representation. H equal to, where H is the order of the group. We have already studied the total number of, it represents, H is equal to total number of symmetry operations. For example, for C2V, H equal to 4, because there are 4 symmetry operations. So there are 4 irreducible representations. There are 4 classes, symmetry classes, symmetry operations. Therefore, there are 4 irreducible representation. The rows are called characters. The rows are called characters. The columns are called the dimensions. Using this great orthogonality theorem, GOT, the following 4 simple rules are obtained. These are also called the important properties of irreducible representation of a point group. These 4 simple rules are applied to derive the character tables for various point groups. So these rules are very, very important in group theory. According to the first rule, the total number of symmetry operations is equal to order of the point group. Okay. The number of irreducible representation in a point group is equal to number of symmetry classes. Okay. So here for ammonia molecule, you see here for ammonia molecule, C3V, the point group for ammonia molecule is C3V. There are 6 symmetry operations. You see, there are 6, 3 plus 2, 5. 6. Therefore, H equal to 6. There are 6 symmetry operations. Okay. But you see C3 1, C3 2, C3 3. C3 3 is nothing but C1, that is equal to doing nothing, E. Okay. So there are 2 symmetry operations, C3 symmetry operation. They form a group or class. Okay, and similarly, there are sigma v operations. There are vertical plane of symmetry. There are 3 vertical plane of symmetry along the NH axis. There are 3 NH bond. Therefore, there are 3 sigma v's along the bond axis. Therefore, sigma v prime, sigma v double prime. These 3 form a class. There are 3 classes only. You see, although there are 6 symmetry operations, only there are 3 class. Therefore, there are 3 irreducible representations. That's what here this rule says. The number of irreducible representations in a point group is equal to number of symmetry classes. So, number of symmetry classes equal to 3. That is equal to number of irreducible representation, gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3. See, for why these are not grouped? For water molecule, for C2V, This is abelian group we have studied. They are commutative. Any two symmetry operations are commutative. That is A cross B equal to B cross A. But in the case of ammonia C3B, this belongs to non-abelian group. Any two elements, any two symmetry operations are non-commutative, that is A cross B not equal to B cross A. Therefore, if it is an abelian group, then H equal to number of classes. But if it is non-abelian group, then H not equal to number of symmetric classes. Okay, please remember this. This is very, very important. According to the second rule, in second rule, the columns are taken. In third rule, rows are taken. Okay. In fourth rule, multiplication of two rows. Okay. Here, columns, according to the second rule, you square this k1 square, k2 square, k3 square, k4 square. That is equal to h. Okay, for example, here k1 square, k2 square, k3 square, etc. equal to h. Summation of ki square. Therefore, this sum of squares of the dimensions of the irreducible representation of symmetry operation E, in a point group is equal to the order of the group. So, according to the second rule, the sum of the squares of the dimensions of symmetry operation E, okay, that is symmetry for E only, this is applicable, this second rule. Therefore, this is equivalent to summation of I, character of or dimension of I varies 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Therefore, this one k1 square plus k2 square of E whole square equal to H. I have given one example so that you can understand this rule. What is third rule? It says the sum of the squares of the characters in the rows. Okay. Here you square k1 square and you put 1 here, and then l1 square, m1 square, you put 1 here, 1 c2 is there, 1 e is there, 1, so 1 n square equal to h. So it is mathematically stated the sum of the squares of the characters rows in any irreducible representation of a point group is equal to the order of the group, order of the point group. This is mathematically simply stated as summation of all the symmetry operations gp is nothing but number of symmetry operations in this class. For example, here only it makes a difference. Here for this symmetry class GP equal to 2. For symmetry class C sigma V, you have GP, therefore 3. Okay, so let us apply this for C2V point group and C3V. Let us apply this to rule to C3V. So let us square the k1. So 1 k1 square, 2 l1 square. Okay. If all are 1, k1 square plus l1 square plus m1 square equal to 6, order of the group. Okay, equal to 6. Therefore, k1, 1, only 1 e is there. Therefore, 1 into k1 square. There are 2 c3 operations. Therefore, 2 into, that is GP, 2 into L1 square, then 3 plus 3 M1 square equal to 6. This is the final rule, rule number 4. According to this rule number 4, the characters of different irreducible representation. See, this is gamma 1, the characters of irreducible representation gamma 1. These are the characters of irreducible representation gamma 2. So, the characters of different irreducible representations are orthogonal to each other. This is the left hand side of the this is the left hand side of the great orthogonality theorem. Okay, that is equal to 0 because del Kronecker delta, we have studied in quantum mechanics, delta ij equal to 0 when I not equal to j. So this is now ij. Therefore, gamma 1, gamma 2 for same not for different irreducible representation. In the earlier, we have considered only the same irreducible representation. Here, so or in other words, the multiplication, the squares of the sum of multiplication of characters of different irreducible representation are orthogonal to E0. Orthogonal means 0, equal to 0. This is mathematically represented in this form. Okay, summation of R, all the symmetry operation, GP, chi I. Okay, just to put chi I, R and chi J, character of, for example, character of E and next character of E here, K2. Therefore, K1 into K2 and 1. So, this is, let us apply this, the characters of different irreducible representations are orthogonal to each other, that is equal to 0. Now, let us apply this rule for C2V point group and C3V point group so that you will understand. First, 1 is there, therefore GP, there is only one symmetry operation in this class. And next, K1, okay, this K1 into K2 and 1, L1 into L2, etc. This is for gamma 1, gamma 2. Similarly, you can write for gamma 2, gamma 3, gamma 3, gamma 4. By using this rule and other rules, the unknown elements K1, L1, the values of these elements are obtained. In the next class, we will see how the character tables are obtained for C2V, C3V point group, how these elements are obtained by using this rule. For example, for gamma 1, gamma 2, here 1, therefore 1 into K1 into K2. Next, this 2, GP is there, therefore 2 into this symmetry, this one for the same symmetry operation C3. This is the character of the ith irreducible representation, therefore L1 into L2 plus 3, because GP, number of symmetry operation in this class, G3 into M1, M2. Similarly, for gamma 2, gamma 3 are obtained. Okay. This is not required here, but what we have already seen, the matrix representation for identity element. This is the matrix representation, or this is called the transformation matrix for symmetry element E. Let us operate on an atom whose coordinates x, y, z. So on doing symmetry operation, there is no change in the atomic position. Therefore, doing nothing, there is no change after this symmetry operation. So E, you know that E is doing nothing. Doing nothing is also symmetry, is an operation. Okay. Now, inversion symmetry, this is the matrix representation. This is also called a transformation matrix, X, Y, Z. And it becomes on symmetry operation, it moves diagonally minus x minus y minus z. Therefore, the position changes. Similarly, this is the matrix representation for plane of symmetry, xy plane of symmetry, xz plane of symmetry, etc. Thank you for watching.